Hello, Internet. Today we are going to talk about Warp. Warp is a new terminal that was shipped, I think, about 2 years ago and is now quite stable and very, very useful. It is basically just a nice terminal, modern and with very small, comfortable features. And alongside that, it's still like just a terminal. So don't get your hopes up for super fancy stuff. Basically, one of the pitches that they have is, first of all, you have like kind of blocks. That means that if you now, do we have any content here? We don't have anything. So let's just get in it, just so we'll have something in this terminal. And we can now, I don't know, we can list the contents of the Git directory. And if we pipe it into some shell command, doesn't really matter. This output is now saved within one block, and this block can be like copied and like with the command only the output. Both not very useful if you ask me. Like, I think I haven't used this feature at all, not even once. Like, if I wanted to copy something, I would just basically cut that into, well, clip copy and paste that, right? So, like, I don't know, a feature of Warp, but the block slicing is nice, but I don't use the copy feature. Apart from that, it is rendered usually very nicely. It supports splitting quite easily if you want to split panes. With let's actually turn on key capture, and then you'll actually be able to see that. So if I command D, I think, yeah, command D is splitting the capture, and now we like have a split screen. We can split again, and that's quite nice. We can close things with just closing the terminal. What else can we say? We can clear not only the screen, but we can also clear the history of the blocks with Command K, which basically means that there is no scroll back. This is basically just a new, like, it completely wipes the buffer. Anything useful other than that? I don't know. Like, it has light and dark themes. Sorry, flash warning. Yeah, that's the light theme. That's the dark theme. Yeah. That's actually. Yeah, nothing fancy here. Usually the dark theme is nice. There's like a co-op thing that I haven't used and it's not interesting. You do have subshells. In order for you to actually take advantage of Warp's blocks feature within subshells, you need to like warpify the subshell, which is basically just a way to say Warp is doing a lot of black magic in order to make this block thing happen. So if you want for that to work within like arbitrary shells, you need to do something about that. As you can see, Bash is not warpified, and then we can just click this warpify subshell thing. And that now has, as you can see, done a lot of crap into like dumped a lot of crap into this shell. And now, for some reason, this is now like kind of working, but not completely. But you do have blocks, but yeah, anyhow, working. But rough around the edges, basically. Not something that, to write home about, if you ask me. We can just exit the subshell as usual. What else do I use, which is like a feature of Warp? Oh, just text editing is like super nice. If you just edit text, you can select it like a text editor with command option shift and just going as if it's just a Google Doc. You can also quote things easily with just selecting things and quoting them. So basically, the text editing experience on this shell is more like a text editor than just like a regular Vim or Bash shell that you're used to when you're SSHing into stuff. Speaking of which, you can SSH into things. Let's take like an instance that I have alive here. Let's copy this SSH command, and if we log into it, so if we SSH into just a regular instance, we can still quote stuff like that, and it's like just working. So that's really nice and not at all trivial to implement, probably. Anyhow, yeah, we can exit this SSH session. This also works, I think, for Docker if we just run, I don't know, dash dash rm dash dash interactive just Ubuntu bash. We can warpify this shell as well. And it now also like just works. And we have that working. So that's really nice. The fact that we can just like step into shells and step out of them, and like things are like still preserving like the native shell user experience is really nice. In terms of prompts, so the usual prompt that comes with Warp is something that they have like custom made. It's somewhere here. We can use Warp's prompt. We can restore this default. Yeah, and if we save that and we go here, that's the default prompt, which basically gives us like our directory and our Git branch. And if we touch some README file, then you'll also see like a plus minus count of the amount of diffs, amount of files that we have here. If we add this README, it will still be counted as if it's well, not committed. Basically, everything that's either staged or untracked is going to be counted in this plus minus counter. We are getting like, I don't know, nice things like the amount of time it takes to complete a command. Usually not that interesting, but sometimes useful. Very good if you are like trying to measure stuff and you forgot to write time before your command. That is like kind of useful, but also like I don't know, I would still like use an actual benchmark tool like Hyperfine if you'd actually want to benchmark things. I wouldn't count on the terminal. Other features that I'm using, subshells, we've talked about that. I'm not using the Teams feature. Oh yeah. You have an AI in your shell if you'd like. If you forgot how to do stuff, you can just say kubectl change my context to another one. And it will load an a suggestion and would actually give it to you. And as you see, like the context name is like a templated. And if we now press enter, it will actually give us a minute to actually. It will actually, yeah, point our cursor into directly injecting strings into the right place, and we can actually toggle between parameters given that there are more than one. So that is super useful. And you have a complete like chatbot here on the right, which is like a dumbed down version of GPT 3.5, I would guess. Nothing fancy, but it is useful that you have that without actually going to your browser. Usually it's not like I don't use that, don't use it very often, but sometimes it's nice. I don't know. You have some features here. None of them are like super special or very interesting. You can set which editor is the default one when you command click things. So if we now let's actually, yeah, if we hover around README MD and I click that with command click, you would see that. Oh shit, Warp has done like a markdown preview thing that is broken. So let's disable this feature because I do not care for it. Markdown. Can we markdown? Select closest. No, that's not the thing. Features. Terminal, workflows, keys, editor. I wonder if that's only let's touch I don't know something dot py. This file is now opened with Sublime because that's the default. Yeah, so let's just delete this file, delete this readme. Let's go back to my shell, which is my prompt is like the default of omazesh, which is, I don't know, I prefer that to like WAPS prompt for a lot of things. But both of them do the like good stuff. By the way, we do have things like if we now I don't know, let's open a subshell and let's exit one. That will now be colored in red, so you know this one has failed and not exited there cleanly. And also, you do have another nice thing, which is like for long-running tasks. Let's actually spin up a long-running task. So let's just sleep, I don't know, for 120 seconds, and then this true. Do nothing successfully. So that will at some point this will notify us. So that would be nice. I will move my face in order for that to be visible to you whenever we finish that. And once that is happening in the background, what else can I say that's nice or not so nice? So first of all, okay, things that are not so nice. If we actually create another window and we bring it up, let's bring those side by side now. If I want to zoom in this window or zoom this window out, it actually zooms both, which is not ideal. Sometimes I'd want to not zoom everything in the same way. So right now it's all synced. So keep in mind this is a limitation. Other things that are kind of broken. So for long commands, it's not working that well. And also auto completions are like non-trivial. We do get like useful stuff, which is if I just write Python and I do get like a very nice completion menu. And also like the history is super useful, and also we can like Control R and look up through the history, which is very nice. And it's like the same Control R that you're used to, but you can browse it very easily instead of like tapping away with Control R yourself. So that's nicer than like normal terminals. Also, like browsing files is very nice. If we look at, I don't know, stuff here, then we can basically tab away. Also, we get like a very nice menu. Nothing fancy though, but just useful. As you can see, it's always like suggesting, but most of the time it's actually suggesting something. And we can use that, which is like useful. Sometimes it's quite eager, by the way. So if like I sometimes find myself when I'm CDing into another directory, and let's actually take, I don't know, let's CD back into streams. It sometimes autocompletes to do like one more thing that's like one more directory than I'd want it to, but usually it's fine. What else can we say about this terminal? So, let's just conclude the most of the stuff that's happening here. Oh, by the way, I see that this has not rung the bell, which is kind of sad. I thought 2 minutes is enough. Features. Receive a desktop notification from warp if a command takes longer than 10 seconds to complete. If a command prompts you to enter a password. Okay, so I might not be okay, I might need to be not in focus and work for this to work. So let's actually do that. Let's test that. So let's sleep for 15 seconds, then actually false. Let's like fail this and let's focus on another window. And it did not notify me, which is kind of annoying. If we actually let's minimize this. Okay, doesn't seem to be working for some reason, and I am not in the mood of debugging that live, so we'll just ignore that. Sometimes it notifies you, sometimes it doesn't. What else can we say about this terminal? Not a lot. So path editing is not working as nice as you'd want it to be. So if you now brew install something new, let's try to, I don't know, what kind of tool do I not have and I would want to have? Let's actually uninstall. Okay, so let's uninstall gRPC curl. And we can now brew install that again. And actually, you know what? Let's open a new tab so we will have like a fresh path. We don't have gRPC curl anymore. I mean, it does not exist. As you can see, it's marked as with like a red line of like not in path. And if we now brew install that, even though it will be on the path once we install it. Warp does not really refresh its path. It does not rescan the path every time. So gRPC curl is actually on the path, and if we actually run that correctly, if we just would type things, so it is on the path. But warp does not recognize that unless we actually do a hard refresh and like open a new shell and then. We would have gRPC curl here. So yeah, these are like the minor complaints. All in all, I think this terminal is awesome. I think I'm quite happy using it, and it has like a very nice feature set. I do sometimes envy Item for some of its features, but usually not. Like usually, this is good enough for me, and. I will continue to use that terminal. So, like, all in all, I would recommend. Give that a try. I would recommend just going there, and I will probably add a link for Warp in the video description. So, yeah, have fun with it. Okay, see you in the next video. Bye for now.